Yes, very good morning, students. In the previous session, I have explained the PVC synthesis, how the PVC has synthesized. So just let us recall how the PVC is synthesizing. What is the full form of PVC? PVC is polyvinyl fluoride. And how the polyvinyl fluoride is synthesizing? Polyvinyl fluoride is synthesizing by the additional polymerization of vinyl fluoride. See here, the vinyl fluoride is adding for n number of times to synthesize the polyvinyl fluoride. But before that, we have synthesized the vinyl fluoride by using ethyne and the hydrochloric acid. Ethyne is also called as the acetyne. So now let us see the today's topic, that is Bakelite. Bakelite is also called as phenol formaldehyde resin. Why we are calling Bakelite as the phenol formaldehyde resin? Because Bakelite is synthesizing by the combination or by adding the two monomers. One is phenol and the formaldehyde. And one more thing, Bakelite is one of the condensational polymer. What is mean by the condensational polymer? If any polymer is synthesizing by the loss of groups or the molecules, that is called the condensational polymer. And Bakelite is an important thermosetting resin named after the scientist Bakeland, who synthesized this resin in the year 1909. Yes, so how the Bakelite name came? Bakelite name came from the name of the scientist. What is the name of the scientist? The name of the scientist is the Bakeland. Bakeland is the name of the scientist. And he has synthesized this polymer in 1909. The condensational reaction of phenol and formaldehyde in the presence of acid or alkali catalyst and at proper temperature produces the phenol formaldehyde resin or the Bakelite resin. So how this Bakelite resin is synthesizing? By the condensational polymerization of phenol and formaldehyde in the presence of acid or the alkali catalyst. What is alkali catalyst here? Alkali is nothing but the base catalyst. Either in the presence of acid or in the presence of base catalyst, we are going to synthesize the Bakelite. Yes. So Bakelite is involving the three steps. What are the three steps? What are the three steps? We have the three steps. The first step is formation of orthomethylal phenol, paramethylal phenol. It is also called as orthohydroxymethyl phenol and parahydroxymethyl phenol. And the second step is, second step is formation of novolac, and the third step is formation of the Bakelite. Yes. So let us see the first step. In the first step, we are going to synthesize orthohydroxymethyl phenol, parahydroxymethyl phenol, or we can also call it as orthomethylal phenol, paramethylal phenol. The initiation reaction of phenol formaldehyde in the presence of acid or alkali produces orthohydroxymethyl phenol or parahydroxymethyl phenol. And this is the formation of the orthohydroxymethyl phenol, parahydroxymethyl phenol. But before that, I will take a whiteboard now. By taking the whiteboard, I will explain you. See here, you know what is the phenol structure. This is the phenol structure. We can put the circle or we can put the alternative double bonds here. This is the phenol. And it is reacting with the formaldehyde. You know what is the structure of formaldehyde? Either in the presence of acid catalyst or in the presence of base catalyst. So now I'm taking the acid as the catalyst here. Yes, initially the formaldehyde is reacting with the acid catalyst to produce a cation. See here, this acid, that means H plus, is attacking on the formaldehyde. What is formaldehyde? HC double bond O, H, is reacting with H plus. These two are reacting with each other. Now here we know that oxygen is having highly electronegativity, so immediately oxygen is donating the electron towards the H plus. So when oxygen donates the electron towards H plus, what we will get here? HC(O) single bond hydrogen. Yes. So now here oxygen is donating the electrons towards the H plus. Oxygen can bond with only two atoms, or it can bond only two. Yes, because oxygen valency is two. So already oxygen is having two bonds. Again, one new bond came, so it gets the electron deficiency because oxygen donated the electron towards the hydrogen. Yes, sorry, hydrogen. So if oxygen is having the positive charge, it is not stable. It is unstable because oxygen is having highly electronegativity. So immediately what will happen here? This bond is breaking and it is gaining one of the electron towards it. When it is gaining the electron towards it, what we will get? The double bond will be converts to the single bond. H single bond, C single bond, H. These are as it is. But wherever we have the double bond here, the double bond has converted as a single bond. And now O H. Now is there any positive charge? No, there is no positive charge because one of the electron is accepted towards it. Positive, negative will be neutral. But now this carbon gets the electron deficiency. So carbon gets the positive charge. This we can write as, CH2. Yes, see here, carbon is connecting to the two hydrogen. So we can write CH2. And what is charge there on the carbon? Which charge is there on the carbon? Positive. Single bond OH. So what is this? This is also called as the methylol cation. This is a methylol cation. You no need to write all these steps from here to here. You no need to write. You can write simply this one. HC double bond OH plus. HC double bond OH plus. So let us write the first step here. Phenol. When phenol is reacting with formaldehyde in the presence of acid or base catalyst, but I have used the acid as a catalyst, in the presence of acid catalyst. So I said no, you don't need to write all these things. So when these two are reacting with each other, what we are getting? We are getting the CH2 plus OH. Yes. So now the CH2 plus OH is called a methylol cation, which is attacking at ortho position and the para position. In one case, it is attacking at the ortho position, and in another case, it is attacking at the para position. So when it is attacking at ortho position, that is called ortho methylol phenol, or ortho hydroxy methyl phenol, and another one para hydroxy methyl phenol. Yes, so this is ortho hydroxy para hydroxy phenol formation, that is step one. Now let us see the step two. What is step two here? Step two is formation of the novel atom. And how that novolac is synthesizing? Now, everyone, you understood this, how orthomethylalphenol, paramethylalphenol has formed. And the second step, novolac is synthesizing. How the novolac is synthesizing? This orthohydroxy and parahydroxymethylphenol, these two are reacting with each other. Orthohydroxy and parahydroxymethylalphenols, these two are reacting with each other to produce the novolac. These two are undergo internal, that means self-condensation reaction. These are undergo condensational reaction to produce the novolac. So I'll explain you now how that novolac is synthesizing. Just I will erase this. So now let us see how the Novolac is synthesizing. Now everyone, you know what is the structure of orthomethylalphenol. This is phenol. This is orthomethylalphenol. And Novolac is synthesizing due to reacting 2:1 ratio of orthomethylalphenol and the paramethylalphenol. That means 2 moles of orthomethylalphenol and 1 mole of paramethylalphenol. This is the paramethylalphenol, but I said now 2 moles of ortho and 1 mole of paramethylalphenol. 2 moles of ortho and 1 mole of paramethylalphenol. Already I wrote 1 mole of ortho and 1 mole of para. I am going to write another mole of ortho now. But I said in the last class that the adjacent position of the functional group is the ortho. Either this or this, both are the ortho positions only. Now I'm going to write CH2OH here. We can write the CH2OH either at the left side or at the right side because both are the ortho positions only. Now let us see what is condensational reaction. I said now 2:1 ratio of ortho and paramethylalphenols are undergo condensational reaction. Condensation means there is a loss of groups at the molecules. See here, initially there is no groups on the benzene, but why I kept the single bonds here? Because nothing is there means there is a hydrogen is present on that. If there is any functional group, there is no hydrogen. But nothing is there means there is a hydrogen. We know the benzene formula is C6H6, but we are not representing the hydrogen at every carbon. But at every carbon, we have the hydrogen. Yes, here we have an hydrogen. Here also we have one hydrogen. Now these are undergo condensational reaction. What is condensation? Loss of group. This hydrogen, this OH is eliminating in the form of water molecule. This hydrogen, this OH is eliminating in the form of water molecule. And when the water molecule is eliminating, what we are getting now? We are getting the new bond. What bond we are getting now? We are getting the new bond. So now the new bond is forming between these two and new bond is forming between two. Yes. So that is the formation of the Novolac. So like that, Novolac is synthesizing. How the Novolac is synthesizing? By reacting 2:1 ratio of ortho and the paramethylalphenol on condensational reaction, Novolac is synthesizing. Now the third step is the Bakelite formation. And the Bakelite is synthesizing due to reacting Novolac, not ortho and paramethylalphenol. No need to represent this. Directly Novolac is reacting. Directly Novolac is reacting with each other. That means this is undergo internal condensation, self-condensational polymerization to synthesize the Bakelite. Yes. So this is the Bakelite structure. There is no short way to explain to remember the structure of Bakelite. So you have to practice the structure of Bakelite. This is the structure of Bakelite because this is one of the molded structure. How this molded structure is forming? Due to molding the Novolac internally. There is n number of Novolacs are undergo internal molding, internal condensational and internal molding. We are getting the Bakelite structure. This is the synthesis of Bakelite. So now let us see what are the properties and applications of Bakelite. Bakelite is a hard, rigid and withstand very high temperatures. They have excellent heat and moisture resistance. They have good chemical resistance, resistance to acids, salts and many organic solvents. But it is attracted by alkalis due to the presence of OH group. Yes, I said now this is not a reacting and this is having more resistance power to the chemical. But it is attracting towards the alkali because of the presence of OH group. That is only the drawback of Pecalite. And they have good abrasion resistance. That means rubbing resistance. It can bear even for the rubbing resistance. And they have electrical insulation characteristics. It is a good electrical insulator. The Pecalite is a good electrical insulator which can be using in the electrical industry and electronic industry as the best electrical insulator. And these are the properties of Pecalite. And one more property, it is a good anionic exchanging resin. Exchange OH group with other anions. In ion exchange method, in our water chemistry, we have seen the ion exchange process. That is the ion exchange method. In the ion exchange method, we are using the resins. Resins are nothing but the polymers. What are the uses of those polymers? Those polymers are exchanging the cations and the anions in the water sample. Even our resin, that means our Pecalite polymer, also capable to exchange the cations from any sample because of the presence of OH group. Low molecular weight grades have excellent bonding strength and adhesive properties. That means sticking properties. These are the properties of the Pecalite. Now let us see what are the engineering applications of the Pecalite. It is used for making electrical insulator parts like switches, plugs, switchboards, etc. For making molded articles like telephone parts, cabinet of radio and televisions. As an anion exchange resin in water purification by ion exchange method in boilers. As an adhesive, that means it is acting as a binder, seem like Fevicol. For grinding wheels, etc. In paints and the varnishes. For making bearings using in propeller shocks, paper industry and rolling mills. So these are the applications of the Pecalite. Yes. So with this, we have completed the plastics. In the next class, I will complete all the fibers because all the fibers, we have only two fibers. The two fibers are very, very simple and very similar to each other. And the last one is the rubber. In the next class, I will complete the fibers and half of the rubbers. And afterwards, I will start the conducting polymers. Yes. So thank you so much, ma'am. So with this, I'm going to end today's session.